Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. Today, what I wanted to talk to you all about was some disk utilities that I prefer to use when I'm using Linux. So let's go take a look. So if we launch disks, this is the Gnome Disks utility, and I personally really like this. So I got a couple drives in my system, and you can see right here that I'm able to actually take a look at them. So as you can see, this one I have Linux on, and you can see it's 24 gigs free right now, yada, yada, yada. I need to get a bigger drive for the system, but let's say I wanted to look at the stats on the drive. I can actually come in here and look at the smart data. I can see that it's running 68 degrees Fahrenheit, 20 degrees Celsius. It's probably about 68 degrees in the room that I'm in with the computer right now, so that sounds about right. Anyway, you can see here this drive is about 9 months old, 8 months and 24 days old, and as you can see, it seems to be okay. In fact, overall assessment is disk is okay. Now, we could actually start doing a real actual test. I'm not going to do that today, though. We can go ahead and we could, and this is something I really like to do, is create a disk image. So what I will do with the create disk image options, I use this to back up Raspberry Pis. I often will just unplug them periodically when they're running something important, and I will plug that card into the computer, and then I will go into Gnome Disks, and I will say create a disk image, and it will give me a file that is a binary perfect match to what is on the SD card. And so if that SD card gets corrupted, or I'm, you know, testing something and it breaks something real bad, I don't know how to fix it, I can just flash that image back using the disk utility, the Gnome Disk utility application, by using the restore image option. And in theory, you could do this with full hard drives, but I've really only ever done it with SD cards. But hey, it's interesting. You could also use this to write regular ISO files, as I've done in the past, to a USB key. So I think it's safe to say that there's some pretty powerful stuff here. We can obviously format the disk and such as well, but it's really pretty standard stuff. All right, let's go look at another utility. All right, so if we take a look here, let's look at the disk-free utility. I'm going to make this terminal bigger for you. But if we do disk-free-h, we get this. And this is it right here, everybody. And you can see I have all my drives, including my snaps drives, because those are also a thing, in the system right here. So we can see all the specs I have out of all of my systems. And yeah, I'm definitely going to have to clear some files off this drive, as I was literally saying earlier. Anyway, so we have that. And one last command I like to use is called the dd command. And I don't think, yeah, we may need to do the, yeah, let's do --help. There we go. But what this is, the dd command is actually pretty interesting, because you can actually copy a file, convert it, and format it according to the settings. This is an old program, and they use that term for settings, the arguments. But what I will do is sometimes I will use this either to back up a drive, to clone a drive, or to take an ISO file and put it on a USB key as well. This is something you could do if you don't want to use Gnome Disks, for example. And you also can use this if that you have, say, a system that is command line only, because Gnome Disk is a GUI utility, and so you need to have a graphical user interface set up. So that's how it works. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed my couple little disk utility options, little things to manage disks. Another honorable mention is the gparted utility, which I've used in the past for partitioning drives and the like. Well, everybody, thanks for watching Open Source Tonight. Let me know your thoughts in the comments about all these different drive tools, and tell me if you like any of them or what you use them for, etc. And thanks for watching. Goodbye, everybody.
And action.